Oh, just tell me when recording's
is gone.
It's gone. So,
it's up now. Or...
Where'd it go?
It's gone. No, it's on.
Where'd it go?
Oh my god!
Yes, and welcome to this private recording session of Drake's lecture on how to play Exalted.
It's not how to play Exalted. This is what the fuck Exalted even is.
Oh right, I'm sorry. That's for the next weekend.
Yes.
There will be a test on this, so please take notes.
No.
Yeah.
No, not yet.
I can't.
Not yet.
That's for school time.
I can't even hold my head up. How do you expect me to hold a pencil?
Why are you here if you can't hold your head up?
Have a mental pencil, then. Okay. Okay. In the beginning, there was nothing. But then the primordials fucking woke up, which apparently they always existed, which is a bit of fluff that I just realized exists. So these ancient beings that just kind of existed since the beginning of the multiverse decided, fuck it, I'm tired of sleeping. And they just kind of sat around talking to each other for too fucking long. Then they got bored, like really bored.
Created 4chan.
You kid, but that's besides the point. They created the universe, and they started fucking around with it like a fucking sandlot, basically. You know how in kindergarten, the children will just, like, play in a sandbox and topple things over?
We got pebbles.
Sad.
Pebbles and disappointment.
Yeah, for the children who got sand in the audience.
Lucky bastards.
That was pretty much what the primordials did, except on like a millennia, like a few millennia long, and it was sculpting a whole planet. They also created a universe that also existed aside from this one planet, but this one planet is where they decided to fucking chill. So, you know, fucking... Eventually, we got too bored of just constantly sculpting and changing shit on this planet, so they decided, I want things to look at that do their own stuff. So they invented humans. Yeah. They did this over, like, what the fuck song is this?
I don't know, but it fits.
This Why is from it the gym leader battle theme?
It's good.
I don't know.
Fair enough, I guess. Yeah, they invent humans after an indescribable amount of time. That was nice of them. They went for like a million versions where fossils of human, like human predecessors came. So humans exist, and for a while, humans progress normally. I think they actually get to like our tech level, basically. Untehano. You're here just in time for the primordials getting bored of human shenanigans. They create a modern society. Then the primordials get fucking bored. So they decide, okay, I'm bored of these humans doing their own thing. So they kind of topple everything like a sandcastle and say, worship me, bitch. And so it was done. So... for a long time after that, humans just worshipped the primordials just as a fact of life. Pretty much like ancient civilization or like Stone Age tier. Because the primordials didn't really want them getting too advanced again because they saw too much of that. And they're assholes, so.
Yeah.
But eventually, the primordials got bored of controlling the planet. So they were like, I don't want to do this anymore. So they invented the gods. The gods exist now. And I should note that this is not like only the sun, moon, etc. are gods. In Exalted's universe, everything has a god, quote unquote, attached to it. Every individual bed of grass, every fucking gust of wind, etc. But most are so shit that they're barely better than the average mortal. Because they're so insignificant in scope. Important gods, though, like the goddess of paperwork, are like super powerful because their domain is so prevalent, and it indirectly and directly gets them so much worship and motes of fucking power.
Paperwork thinking.
Yes, yes.
He's gonna send war, or feasts. But no, paperwork.
Yes, the goddess of paperwork is one of the most powerful gods in the entire pantheon.
Nice.
Shaking. And it's a fucking librarian.
Yes, literally a librarian. An almighty librarian. That's besides the point. Eventually, the gods are like, I don't want to work for these asshole primordials anymore. So they come to the conclusion that they should start a war to kill the primordials, but they'd lose in 1v1s or in just a straight up brawl. So the gods decide, okay, we need an army. So they make an army by creating the exaltations, you know, the things the whole game is based on. So, exaltations are created, they're handed out secretly to the most badass of humanity. And over time, more of these exaltations are created. Fun fact, these exaltations were created with the help of the bullied primordial, pretty much the primordial of machines and machinations and complex systems. He was bullied because he was nice to humans, often. And this just made him seem too personable for all these other primordial assholes. So they bullied him, like legit. And he decided, fuck these guys. And he helped make the exaltations with the sun, moon, the maidens of fate, and the fucking dragons of the elements, which are the main gods behind everything. To go through the types of exalted, the dragon-blooded, by far the most numerous, are the only exalted that have their exaltations as heritable traits. The main difference between this and actual genetics is that if you develop your exalted powers, they become heritable. Acquired traits for your exaltation are heritable. This is why the modern aristocracy and exalted are getting it wrong, because they think the starting point is what matters when it comes to heritable strength. No, it's the end point of when they have the kid. Anyways, the other ones were the sidereals, which are like the time-space bureaucrats. They manage time, they have a bunch of fucky as hell charms and powers, and in general, they're pretty cool. Oh, and their martial arts are bullshit, but I'll get to that in the mechanics lecture. Then there's the Lunars, which are the exalted of the moon. They get chosen for exceptional determination. And they're pretty much hyper-powerful, shape-changing martial artist dryads. They're pretty great. And then finally, the Solars. The Solars are mechanically the most powerful, and they're the chosen of the sun. You get chosen for being exceptional badass. Like, if you do something really fucking cool, you get a solar exalt.
And if
in
you
general,
fail at that, you become what we are.
Yes, but that's later. That's very much later. The main thing of Solars is that they're very specialized people. They are incredible. They're top of their field in a few things, and then just great in everything else. Like, just moderately great. Other exalted who specialize in things that Solars aren't great at can get edges on Solars because of this. Because Solars are pretty much humans, but better in every possible way, by, like, orders of ungodly magnitude.
Human 2.0.
Yeah. And, yeah. They create an army of these exalted fucks. with Dragonblooded as the soldiers, Sidereals as like the fucking CIA, and Lunars as also CIA but also Navy SEALs, and Solars as like the rulers, the strategists, the fucking mechanics and engineers, etc. All the very specialized fields that go into an army. And they win. They beat the Primordials. They kill some of them, like actually kill them, which should be impossible, but they did it anyway. And God. The rest, they imprison. Yes, fuck you, reality. Laws of physics
bends
don't
to my
matter.
Will.
Specifically, Exalted don't have to follow the rules. They have charms and the ability to ignore stuff like the inability to true kill something. They have true killed fucking Primordials before, even though gods couldn't do that.
It's
because
the gods gave them the power to just cheat the universe, basically.
Well, Exaltations grow over time. That's the main difference between them and gods. Gods can get more powerful, but they don't change. They're still the same thing. They can't overcome, adapt, and all that fun shit. Exalted can, and they will, if you give them enough leverage.
Because they're humans.
Yes, and also because the Primordial who invented them wanted them to have an edge over the gods because he didn't like them much.
Did that Primordial die, or is he alive still?
Nah, he left. He is fine. He just decided to do his own thing.
So where is
so
he,
So he's
then?
Good. He's off in the wild. He's off in Feyland. You don't have to worry about him. He's doing his own shtick. He's handling
like
his own
the
business.
Idea of him.
Well, he still comes around and does stuff in creation every once in a while, but he's a chill dude. People like him. Even the gods like him because he's just even though he doesn't really like the gods too much.
Hey, the gods are better than the Primordials in his opinion, I'm sure.
Yeah, because the gods didn't fuck him over for like millennia. He also, his best friends, that Primordial's best friends are humies, fucking humans and that kind of shit, because they're the only people who appreciated what he made and what he could do. Gods don't care because magic, and Primordials don't care because they're infinite beings of cosmic importance. Humans cared about what he is, so he loves them. And he's the most caring extra-dimensional being in the entire setting.
What a nice
but,
guy.
He is a nice dude. He's chill. People like him. But that's besides the point. Oh, he also invented the dwarves, so that's cool.
Okay, this just makes me want to have a campaign centered around him more.
There is an entire campaign setting that is inside of his soul, because he's a Primordial, so he's kind of like a universe in and of himself.
Wonderful, I like him.
It's great. I played in one of those campaigns, they're a great time. We're not doing that this time, but we'll do that maybe in another exalt.
Wonderful.
But yeah. For thousands of years after the Primordial God War, everything was fine. The Solars were god kings of reality. The Lunars were their right-hand maidens slash men. The Sidereals were secret police slash specialists. And the Dragonblooded were, like, doing all of the grunt work. They were doing literally all of the grunt work. Because here's the thing. About the Dragonblooded. They're not spectacular on an individual level. They can win battles with Celestial Exalted if they're smart about it, but on an individual level, they're just weaker. But when you get a lot of them and you get them working in tandem, they kick a lot of ass. And the Solars would realize this in the coup. This idea, like, okay, yes, to describe what happened to the still-alive Primordials, they got imprisoned. How? Malphioz, the king of the Primordials, got turned inside out and turned into hell. Literally. He is hell now. Yeah, that's unpleasant for him. All of the other Primordials were imprisoned inside of him, and he's now called the Demon City because he is a world-sized city. As hell now. What is this song?
Who knows?
I can skip it. Give me
I music.
Nah, I don't mind it. It's fine. It's just I want to know what it was.
It's sound.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, no. I have a question.
Hey, I've been here.
How do I make the candy thing?
What?
The candy thing. Like the thing with, what's it called? Drake, you know, like how you're sick and you have the candy thing, except this one doesn't have menthol.
The cough drops?
That's the bitch, yes. No, Gnome, how? You're like, hey, if you get sick, and I'm getting sick, apparently. It's like, bullshit. This is how you do that. And I was like, okay,
it's like
how do I do
out
that?
A list of ingredients and instructions. But, continuing on. Yeah, to continue on why the coup even happened, we have to go to Vyozus, which are the names for the primordials that were imprisoned.
Vyozus.
Yeah, they fucking hate themselves because they lost the war that they probably could have won if they were smarter about it. So they're just like, ah, shit, we fucked up real bad. And for thousands of years, they were just kind of sitting in hell, kind of like lamenting this with demons and that kind of shit as their only friends. Very sad people, those Yozis. But then they decide, okay, fuck these guys. So they decided to concoct the ultimate fuck you with the Great Curse. The Great Curse is the name of the curse that has been placed on all exaltations. It is a cosmic level curse. No one can fix it aside from the god, like the primordial who's currently just like chilling in the wild land. So he's not here, so he can't fix it. And it would also take like millennia anyway, so who cares? So, yeah, that happens. What the Great Curse does is, all exaltations are based on the four temperaments, which are, like, the virtues in Chinese, in a version of Chinese philosophy. This has been co-opted by the Exalted fucking game dev team, because they like it. So, yeah. And the Great Curse, whenever they don't indulge themselves a little bit, or like keep themselves leveled out in terms of temperaments, they will slowly build a limit. That's the name. That's a bitch. Limit is the name of the thing that builds up in an exalted soul over time when they don't level themselves out and keep mellow and that kind of shit. They will eventually hit a limit break, which will make them go extra fucking crazy. And this is, like, terrible. Especially because when the Great Curse was first applied, it was more powerful than it is now. So the limit break would just persist until it was fixed by something. So pretty much all of the soulers at once, because they were blindsided by this, went fucking insane. And became tyrannical assholes. This was the plan because the Sidereals, who realized this and managed to avoid it because they were over in the celestial bureaucracy, so they're mostly fine from the Great Curse. They're good. But no one else is. So they're like, shit, this is terrible. How do we fix this? They came to the conclusion that they needed to coup the Solars, and they were like, but how would we do that? They came to the conclusion they have to use the Dragonblooded. So they assembled a kind of like army of resistance Dragonblooded and offered them pretty much control over the planet. The Dragonblooded in this massive ungodly army completely smacked the Solar's bitch up and they got their asses kicked. The Dragonblooded kicked them out of reality, killed them all, and burned down their highly advanced technology. Because, Dragonblooded, when assembled in whole armies, are fucking terrifying. They're ungodly scary, because all Exalted have this thing called Anima, which is when they spend enough motes, their soul kind of shows, basically. Dragonblooded have something different, where they start, like, if they're a fire Dragonblooded, they'll set like giant parts of air just on magical fire now. This stacks with the number of Dragonblooded in a unit. They had armies millions strong of Dragonblooded all activating Anima Flux at the same time. This kicks ass, and the Solars lost the war hard. All of them were killed, and then their exaltations were boxed up by the Sidereals in heaven. So the Solars super lost. It was not even a contest. But a lot of the Dragonblooded died in the event, and then after the war, the Sidereals just kind of peaced out. Like, we did our job. See ya, bitch. So the Dragonblooded kind of also went a bit crazy and started infighting a lot, which has drastically reduced their numbers from the ungodly numbers that they had pre-infighting. So yeah, that occurred. But finally, the Great Contagion, which was the name for a disease of the wild folk, which are the Fae. The Fae started accidentally actually spreading a disease because they were invading creation. And it was killing everybody. It was going to destroy the entire planet, but one Chadess by the name of the Scarlet Empress managed to man Solar Age global defense systems and fixed the problem. This should have killed her, but she lived anyway. But who cares? So she became Empress of the entire planet. She was ruthless, she was power-mongering, but she was highly effective and nice to the peasants. So she was in power, and people genuinely liked her. This went on for...
people, you don't have to deal with them revolting.
Yeah. This went on... Oh, and I should note, the Scarlet Empress designed her country with, if she died, the whole country would collapse in mind. As a defense against people trying to kill her. Because if she died, everything would go terribly.
Sounds about right.
I mean, it was smart on her behalf. This went on for about 750. Normally, Dragonblooded only live for about 300 to 400. The longest lived, aside from the Scarlet Empress, was 600. So this is... She is super long-lived. She's lived, like, 1,400 years in total. 750 of that was, like, her as Empress. So that's also questionable, but people just assumed she was immortal. She was the most powerful being in the entirety of the world. She could do whatever, and she was smart enough and clever enough and nice enough where everyone just accepted her rule. And she was even-handed enough where she separated the world into satrapies or fiefdoms, which allowed her to keep an even hand on things while not seeming like a power monger, even though she totally was. She made the aristocracy of Dragonblooded to act as both a military component, the actual like administrators, and a beat stick she can use upon either non-Dragon-blooded nobility, or alternatively to work against each other so that no one of them could get too powerful. And this worked for 750 years because she was the hyper-competent matriarch at the top of the totem. But then, she fucking disappeared. No one found her, and no one's seen the body, so they kind of just assume she's dead, but also they don't know, so they're just like, It's a plot point that they're very skeptical of trying to replace her, because if she came back, she'd be pissed if they did that, and they don't want to make her that angry, because she could kick all of their asses. So they're pretty much just like, okay, this is terrible. We're going to appoint a regent and hope to God both she doesn't come back and also we can find somebody that's a good replacement. So that's currently the state of affairs over in the High Court.
Wonderful.
This has also resulted in most of the world gaining de facto independence. Previously, the Shogunate, which is the name of the realm, controlled the entire planet, which is a giant fuck-off planet, to be clear, and is inherently mad. But, yeah, it doesn't control the entire planet anymore, because with her gone now, and all of the individual satraps and such getting more greedy and pocketing more of the tributes, it's gotten to a point where most of the world is de facto independent from the realm. Instead of just autonomous. So this is also terrible, and the realm realizes all of this. They're not dumb. It's that they don't know how to fix it without also getting killed by the other ones. None of them are willing to go all in on a fixing project, because if they do, they're gonna get fucked over by another one. So they have to come. They're all fighting two front wars here on reform and not dying. They're all trying to fix it, it's just that they're too afraid of each other to actually do it. As was partially intended by the absolute monarch empress. Yeah, so it's remarkable that the realm is even still functioning, to be perfectly honest, because it was designed to self-destruct without her. It is a almost testament to how competent these people are that these millennia, almost millennia-long grudges between them haven't exploded into an active hot war yet. But yeah, when the Scarlet Empress disappeared, about a year after that, the Jade Box, or the Jade Prison, depending on who you ask, which was the prison for all the solar exaltations, was cracked. Now, no one's entirely sure in-universe on how or why. We as players know that it was the Yozi and the Neverborn being the killed primordials, but they still exist in the Abyss because you can't actually get rid of them entirely. They still exist as lingering echoes of their once existence. The Yozis think the Neverborn are genocidal madmen because they are genocidal madmen, and that is entirely true. So they don't want to work with the Neverborn at all, but they needed to get the plan going ahead. And the Ebon Dragon was the guy who actually pulled off the plan with magical help from the Neverborn and the Yozis. So they crack the Jade Prison open, and the Solar Exaltations fucking yeet themselves out of there at top speed, because they're now free. But because the Ebon Dragon is right fucking there, he manages to grab a portion of them. It's testament to just how ungodly powerful these exaltations are that they didn't get all of them in this attempt. The majority of the solar exaltations go to the god whose entire job it is to distribute celestial exaltations. He kept this a secret for that whole year. So he cleans them up, fixes their shit up so the Great Curse isn't as, and then starts distributing them again. The Sidereals are pissed about this, understandably, because they were not informed of any of this. But they can't do anything about it, because this god now has super bodyguards, so they can't coup his ass like they did the last time. And he's made some powerful allies in the celestial bureaucracy, so you're not getting these solar exaltations back in prison, bitch. That's pretty much the response that he gave the Sidereals. So solar exalted.
Who are the Sidereals
again?
I'm sorry,
baby.
I kind of zoned out.
The time space bureaucrats.
Oh,
those
the Sidereal guys. Okay.
Yeah, they're pronounced Sidereal. Because
I'm calling them Sidereal because it's easier to understand.
But yeah, Solar Exalted are fucking back. The Lunars, who have been hiding in the jungle for like millions of years at this point, are very happy to hear this news, because they're supposed to be like best friends and lovers and shit. So they're happy about that, and the Soul are exalted, who now exist again as reincarnations, are happy about. Guess who's not happy about that? The fucking Realm, who's only came about as a result of the Soul are exalted getting over from. And they've been teaching the rest of humanity for like 750 years now that Soul are exalted are the anathema to the dragon-blooded civilized society, which is the only society that these fuckers even know at this point. So everyone thinks Soul are exalted are the devil. They also think that Lunars are like the deputy devil, and they don't know the Sidereals exist. Because that was intentional. The Sidereals, to keep themselves as the secret Illuminati of the world, have made it where no one except Exalted can remember them properly. And most Dragonblood Exalted don't realize that Sidereals are Exalted unless they're like super powerful and shit. And like experienced. So the Sidereals again are like, fuck, this is going to cause global instability, and they're correct. But yeah, that's happening in real space. But over in hell, the Ebon Dragon has managed to contain some of the Solar Exaltations. He handed the rest that he captured off to the Neverborn as part of their. This is the only deal he has ever followed fruit on, by the way. I just need to clarify that. Yeah, he manages to keep these Solar Exaltations contained. He has not told anybody how he does this, because I'm telling you right now, and I'm not telling any of you how he does this, it is so disturbing that all of the other Yozis would kill him. That is the level we're talking about, because the Yozis aren't actually, like, super evil. They're just crazy. And they actually do give a shit now about mortals because they realize how important they are. But it's like, they're not just stupid evil, I'm trying to say, I guess. The Neverborn just want to kill everything. The Yozis want to rule everything again.
They're a bit chaotic, that pissing but they aren't evil.
Yeah. They're assholes, but they're not, like, evil evil. The Ebon Dragon is evil evil. And if they found out how he contained these Solar Exaltations, they'd kill his ass immediately.
How did the Ebon Dragon come about again? Like, did he just exist?
He was a primordial. Basically, there's two ways of, like, semi-killing a primordial. There's true killing them, which should be impossible, but happened anyway. Those are the Neverborn. And then there's partial killing them, which results in them changing their identity a little. This happens to all the Yozis. This is why they're worse versions of how they were previously, most of the time. The Ebon Dragon was pretty much the epitome of all things darkness. He was like fucking Morgoth from Lord of the Rings, except way scarier. But then he got partial killed, and now he's a treacherous, lecherous asshole that nobody likes. And the only deal him and his Ebon Dragon persona has ever followed through on was the deal with the Neverborn, because he would have been killed if he didn't. So yeah. He's an asshole. He is the big bad. The rest of the Yozis are just fucking crazy. But yeah, with these Solar Exaltations, they have been supremely fucked with by the Yozis, collectively, and they distribute them 99% of the time to people who are about to get a Solar Exaltation, but then get fucked over. Like, they're about to do something so cool, they become a Solar, but no, they get fucked over by something. Usually something out of their control, or they just fuck up of their, like, in a bit, they fuck up at the last moment, like, they step a little too short and then they lose the Battle of Verlife and that kind of shit. Yeah. The one exception, the only one, is when someone is like, okay, the guy who manifests that one exception is Ligier, the green sun over in the Demon City. He is the main soul of Malphiaz, you know, the Demon King / the Demon City, who is also Hell. So the son of Hell is the main soul of Hell. And he hates Malphiaz because he sees Malphiaz as the manifestation of all the Primordial's failings. It was actually the Green Sun who wanted the Primordials to create their own equivalent of Exalted in the first fucking place to fight and win the goddamn war. And he was resoundingly ignored, but now he has been vindicated. He is the biggest ass-kicker in the entire system. And he's also the most caring demon about mortals, because he doesn't like Exalted, like regular Exalted at all. Because he sees them as pretty much taking a celestial shortcut to magnificence. He likes mortals who, in an effort to surpass celestial bonds, do something so out of this world fucking insane, and then succeed. Like, if you're a satrap or a thief who is fighting a war against, like, a concerted army of Exalted, and you're winning, Ligier is the guy who might hand you an infernal exaltation. If you are like a mistress who, being unwed, manages to take one of the highest courts in the realm under your control, you meet Ligier and get an infernal exaltation. If you do something so out of this world insane that you would not only get a solar exaltation, you've gone a bit beyond that, then you get an infernal exaltation from that guy. He is the biggest ass-kicker in the entire system, and he is actually a cool dude.
He sounds awesome.
Yeah.
He reminds me of an Inuit spirit, but we'll talk about that later. Just remind me of it.
Yeah, it's like, if you go beyond getting a solar exaltation, you get an infernal exaltation from that ass-kicker. It's fucking... But yeah, that's the one exception. The vast majority of Infernals come about from almost becoming a solar exalted bin, getting fucked over. It's because most Yozis are a bit self-hating, and they want other people to share their mindset of hating the world in its current order, to make it easier to like manipulate them and get the plan going. Ligier doesn't really care because he wants to like do shit the way he likes, so whatever. And he's too powerful for anybody to complain. But yeah, Infernals, I'd say, are the second most mechanically powerful Exalted in the system. Also, I'm going to give everyone the book service during the mechanics lecture, but don't read the fluff for the second edition Manual of Exalted Power Infernals. I'm not done with this lecture, by the way, I'm just telling you. Because there was a giant communications fuck-up in the creation of that book, because White Wolf is the best company, that resulted in them not really getting a message across on what the fuck Infernals actually are. So they say that most Infernals are traumatized and can't really get over the dark temptations that their exaltation gives them. But that's wrong, going by literally all the charms that they have. So I go with... they're actually the most sane of all of the Exalted on a typical level, aside from the Sidereals. It's just that they have to be a bit mustache twirling sometimes to keep their relative sanity. They also get like temptations to be a bit like their patron Yozi. And this comes to why the Infernals have the weirdest charm sets and stat shit in the entire system, because I need to clarify. The reason it's so weird is because all the Yozis are based around concepts, and there's like a fuck ton of them, and so there's an ungodly amount of Infernal charms and you kind of have to pick a set of them. So, yeah, it's going to be complicated when I have to get to that, but that's besides the point. The other new exalted type in 2E was Abyssals, and Abyssals, they're the Neverborn's boys. Their job is to basically either rule around in the Abyss or alternatively to eventually destroy everything. Most Abyssals don't want to do this because the Solar Exaltations make them fundamentally good people, but the Neverborn are better at keeping their, like, evil subordinate mooks in line. So whenever they aren't doing some form of destruction, be it against bad or good things, they'll build up their version of Limit, which will eventually release itself by hurting something around them or something they care about. So yeah, playing an Abyssal is genuine evil campaign. And there's only one way to fix that, but it's complicated and it involves not being an Abyssal anymore. But yeah, any questions?
Yes, I was gone for about 5 minutes. What did I miss? I'm recording. It's fine.
Yeah.
Don't worry.
Any questions? Any questions?
Is that the basic lore that we need to know, all of that?
That's a majority of what you need to know, yeah.
Okay, question from my part. Where the hell have Gnome and Yedi?
Cherry is doing something and she'll be back, and Gnome dies occasionally.
Thankfully, I'm recording this and I'm going to put this up on YouTube. Drake's Basic Guide to Exalted Lore.
Yeah, we're going to need that.
I am very glad I was recording this.
But any questions about the setting or anything that you need a clarification on?
Can I get a clarification? Can we please get that Tyrannosaurus Rex in here?
Okay, fine. There is a city in the south, okay, that is fucking... Okay, the south, to describe, it starts off as, like, gentle prairies with seasons and, like, weak season shit. But it progressively gets warmer and warmer until you get to, like, volcanoes and desert and all that fun shit. Yeah. And there is a city there that is a metropolis built out of, like, nearly caved-in first-age solar metropolis ruins that they fixed up a lot. That is called Paragon. It is, like, you know the book that inspired the term Utopia? It's a lot like the society described in that. It's ungodly orderly. And pretty much everyone acts like a machine there, or they're a cog in the machine. That is just... It is ruled by the most powerful mortal in the entire setting, who is an essence free, which is the highest a mortal can possibly get. Mortal who can actually fight exalted because he has a first age magical artifact and he kicks ass. He's the only reason Paragon even functions.
Under Paragon is the T-Rex?
Yes, under Paragon is the T-Rex. Or, I'm misremembering, and it's under the other major city in the south called Gem. Gem is a pretty much city built on and into a mountain that, as its name describes, gets by off of the gem trade. They are the most populous and, like, trade hub of the south desert region. And it's either under Paragon or under Gem there is this regenerating Carnosaur Tyrannosaurus Rex that was genetically engineered by ancient sorcerers to only eat things piece by piece, while preferably keeping the target alive.
What?
Yep, its spit is an anesthetic, and its claws are razors.
Right. Okay, I also have a question.
Yes.
Since there are primordial ones, which from what I understand are like the great ones from what was the guy's name?
Like Lovecraft?
Yeah,
I like to think of them as titans.
There is pretty much Cthulhu, but he's in power armor and under the... Does that
what
answer
the fuck?
Your question?
I guess.
So wait, Drake, did we talk about how the alchemicals came about?
Oh yeah, the alchemicals. They're not super related, but they're a cool story. I don't know how to pronounce this guy's name. I need to pull his name up so I can attempt to say it. I'm not sure I know how to make... I'm gonna just call him the Great Maker because that's his title.
What is his name? I wanted to know his name. Type it out if you
say
need
his
to.
Name. Do it, Drake. Do it. Say his name.
Autochthon? Autochthon? I don't know, man. It's Autochthon. Autochthon.
Autochthon.
Autochthon.
Okay.
Autochthon.
Autochthon. There we go.
No, Autochthon.
Autochthon?
With like a than at the end. Autochthon.
No, I think it's a hard
Autochthon.
T in it. Soft
well,
eight.
According to Google, that's how you pronounce it, because this is a thing from ancient Greece.
Keep in mind, this game loves fucking with your pronunciations.
An original or indigenous inhabitant of a place or aborigin?
Nah, he's a great maker. That's what I'm going to be calling him, because that's his title. So, he decided... I'ma leave, and everyone's just like, goodbye! He took a few billion humans along with him, because the world was getting a bit overcrowded. And they preferred him over living in creation, for obvious reasons. Now, he's off in the middle of scenic nowhere. Actually, I was kind of lying, and I was kind of wrong. He was in the wild, which is the Feylands, but then he went even further beyond, and now he's in what I will describe as pretty much the void or subspace. He's in between universes now. He is where you should never be able to go without a lot of bullshit. But he went there anyway, and that's where he's currently chilling. The humans in his, greater celestial being have made a very complex society that actually puts humans before Exalt. It's a miracle. And because of machines and the tools and all that fun shit there, they actually can kind of do things on a somewhat even playing field as Exalted can. It's great, because Magitek is pretty amazing. But there were problems. There's always problems. Because, one, the Fey folk, they fuck shit up occasionally. Two, he needs people to send out into other parts of Multiverse to handle shit for him. And he needs more materials. He is running out of his internal universe's materials because there's so many peeps there now, and he's got so much shit going on.
Okay.
So he's invented his Exalted Boys, the Alchemicals. Basically, he invented new exaltations, because he's that much of a shit. He doesn't need no fucking gods. And secondly, he still bums around creation occasionally with his influence, and looks for people who have reincarnated a number of times, and has been a good person every time. People who, like, their soul is so unflinchingly good that no matter what reincarnation they've been, 99% of the time they've been a good person.
He basically picks people who are deserving of becoming exalted throughout multiple lifetimes.
Yeah, he's very stringent on this. So that's where when someone he has selected dies, he will gently pick up their soul, bring it over into his pretty much celestial crib, and then give him a new awesome magical metal robot.
That's why I wanted to play Alchemicals.
Yeah, he then either sends them as pretty much spec ops into creation, or alternatively uses him as like internal problem solvers within his own
domain.
Yeah. And yeah, any other questions?
How can I become an alchemical?
Infernal won the vote, so I'm sorry, dude.
Oh god, just make it so when I fail, I die instead of living on.
Biggest oof. But yeah, any other questions from either of you?
Currently not. It's a lot to take in.
Yeah.
I had to zone out several times to keep going.
Do you guys get it, basically?
Well, we get it's fucked.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a bit fucked, but I love it. I love it so much. Don't you just love how the Demon King fucking hates himself?
That was definitely interesting.
Yeah.
In fact, he literally split himself into two, basically, which is his body and his soul. And his soul curses the body that can't even do anything anymore because he fucking hates himself so much.
Yeah, especially because, like, Lygia represents all the good parts about Malphias. That's the main thing. He represents all the benevolence, the chadness, the conquest, the coolness. Being a badass is the Green Sun's purview. That's what Malphias wants himself to be, except on a grander scale. And the Green Sun is that.
Mm-hmm. And so we're the Infernals, the guys who work under him and the other...
Yes...
Oh, Infernals won the...
Quick question, how do Abyssals come about? I may have just missed that, but...
They have a guy from, like...
Yeah, Toastman, go on, I want to see how good you understand him here.
The Abyssals were the... Yeah.
Were the yeah?
God. No. So, you remember there are the, here... Like the old gods?
The guys who died. I was going to ask.
Yeah,
the primordials.
Yeah.
The primordials. And then there are the primordials who got, true killed
fucking
or something.
Yes,
killed.
True killed.
Yeah.
And so
yeah, and
those guys somehow got
back...
exalted stuff and gave it to people.
No. The guys who got true killed but came back, those guys, I don't remember their name, but they're basically like devils and
I
stuff.
I know that.
And the Neverborn, and the Abyssals are the Exalted of the Neverborn.
I was assuming that, but how did the Neverborn get Exalted power to give to
they're
people?
Made from Solar Exaltations.
How did they get Solar Exaltations?
The same way the Yozis got.
Oh, so this was one big deal between all of them, okay.
Yeah. This is their conspiracy get their own exalted. Yeah.
I thought it was just between the Yozis and the dickhead.
No, the Ebon Dragon is one of the Yozis. He's just the biggest dickhead.
Yeah, you'll see in the video.
Yeah. They struck up a deal with the Neverborn, just like, okay, we need Exalted to turn this whole ship around. We fucking hate each other because we have completely different goals, but we need to work together on this. And so they came together, they cracked the Jade Prison open, and then they got some of the Solar Exaltation.
Right, I know that. Okay, so that's all the Exalted.
Yeah, totally.
Well, you haven't given us in-depth explanations about all the Exalted, but we've at least gone over all of them.
Yes. But there's a bit of a problem here, because before they announced Free E, and in 2E-related supplements, because they fucking hate everybody, because it's White Wolf, they decided to tease Exalted types that... were completely
Or completely
and that's
what?
That's just completely different, because, of course.
Well, but we're not dealing with
so
those.
So now you hate your fucking life.
Yeah, I hate everything. Okay, nice. Well, that's not entirely fair. It's
he
not
does love
fair.
His Supers campaign.
Yes. The three semi-exalted types are the Liminals, the Jetiminians, and the Exigents. The easiest to describe are the Exigents, and I think they actually got a book, or it was the very similar ones. Exigents, if I remember correctly, are basically you get to play as a mortal but with a god spark in you, the heavenly spark that makes you about the realm of an exalted in terms of pure bullshit.
Okay.
Through sheer incident, by the way. The other one that is semi-easy to describe are Liminals. Liminals, unless I'm getting the names mixed up, the Liminals are pretty much sidereals that decided, I don't want to work in the heavenly bureaucracy anymore. So they got some sympathetic Fate Weaver spiders and put... How should I describe this? That's not, like, weird or creepy. They made a part of their chest into a habitat for weaver spiders, you know, who weave fate, and this allows them to ignore fate, and they've pretty much created their own exaltation, effectively, through becoming an epicenter of fate bullshit. The other one is the one that is effectively, like, bringing someone back who has been true killed is impossible. I'm making that perfectly clear. When you try to do it as a mortal, you will get your shit pushed in, and you'll turn into this kind of exalted by pretty much one of the what's the fucking term for it? In the Abyss, there's this one lady who's actually a good person, who've never worn fucking hate, that keep it where undead don't exist. That's pretty much her main purview. And she selects people who attempt this and then singles them out like, you're gonna work for me now, bitch.
Because you tried to fuck with my domain.
Yeah. Try to fuck shit up and I'm not allowing. You're not allowed to resurrect people in this setting. So anyone who dies is real fucking dead, and they have to
And they have to what?
There's no resurrection. Only reincarnation. There's no resurrect.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, any other questions? Because, yeah.
In what realm exactly are we gonna start? Like in Hell, in the Abyss, or just in...
No, you're starting in Creation, which is the actual planet. You're okay. All starting as regular Humi boys. Above average Humi boys. But...
Okay.
Anything else?
Don't think so. Currently just organizing my video stuff.
Fair enough.
Yeah, because I'm trying to move like all the videos that I've recorded onto my 2 terabyte storage because my local disk is filling up.
Yeah.
Videos take a lot of space.
Is there anything that you guys would like to know or want clarity?
Well, I would like to know more about the chemicals, can we make but we're not characters. Doing that.
How bullshit can you make your character?
Yes.
Well, you're pretty much going to start playing as, like, pretty much John Wick in comparison to most people. So there is that.
You gotta be okay, John Wick good. In order to get this power.
You gotta be a badass to even get close, man. Yeah, you're
and
all
get angry when dog die. Yeah.
Yes.
Well, everyone gets angry when dog die.
Well, yes. You are all very above average people. You have been trained extensively in whatever you guys choose to make your characters specialize into. It's like, there's this one tutorial about how to play Exalted that's on the internet, but I forgot what it was about or what it was. But I know for the first part of it, you played as an enlightened mortal. And you were like a master swordsmith and like a fucking badass detective, basically. And that's kind of the level you guys are going to be at.
Okay, nice.
A bit below that, but still. You guys do indeed kick ass and chew bubblegum. Nobody, nice. Nobody got that reference?
We're recording.
Yeah,
yes.
Duke Nukem.
Yeah, it's Duke Nukem.
Told you.
Duke Nukem, oh, sorry.
But yeah, any other questions?
So far, not, I guess.
Okay, then I'm just gonna start spouting off random pieces of information. One, there is a system in Exalted that I fucking love. It is basically, whenever you're doing something, if you describe it in a cool or badass way, you get a bonus. It's either one extra dice, two extra dice, or three extra dice. And it goes like this. One extra dice is just you describe it in a good way. Two extra dice is you describe it in a badass way. Three extra dice is like you're doing a crowning moment of awesome where you're doing something so fucking cool that everyone at the table just goes, holy shit. That is what a three dice stunt is.
A three dice stunt doing a triple backflip midair and jumping down and stabbing a god right in the head, huh?
No, it has to have like a level of such storytelling level bravado to it. It's like, it is so fucking cool that it makes the whole campaign.
So, something like at the final boss, charging at him, fucking diving between his legs, ripping his balls off.
Something about that level of what the fuck awesomeness.
Or when you revealed an.
And isn't the rule you have to do this within 6 seconds as well?
Yes, you do have to describe it in a short time frame, as short as you can make it. Or if you're doing multiple actions on your turn for whatever reason, like you've got charms that can allow you to do that, you have to do it for each one within 6 seconds. Yeah, anything else you want clarified?
I don't know. I'm about to stop the recording now.
Okay. I'm gonna just give a bit of fluff on Infernals then. I'd say they're the second strongest Exalted type in terms of just sheer mechanical effectiveness. And this is mainly because their charm tree is so ungodly massive. It is fucking ginormous. Like, holy fuck. There are so many of them. There's so many different variations of them. So you can do a lot of things with Infernals. There's a lot of things you can just do with. So, yeah, that's the main reason why Infernals are so good. It's that they can do so much shit. Especially whenever you start as an Infernal, when you start being an Infernal, be it you were a mortal before or you start the campaign as one, then you're going to have a lot of options available to you because you're going to start with, for an Exalted, a relatively giant amount of options in terms of what the fuck everything related to you is about.
Wonderful. I will become just weird fuck man.
Oh, and there's one extra bonus of being an Infernal. You get a demon helper, buddy.
Nice.
Oh, cool.
Is it random or?
The main one is pretty much a weaver spider that has been repurposed for other things. Basically, they fix your shit up whenever you're like super wounded and that kind of thing.
Oh, Nax joins at the end.
Hello.
Big oof. Apologies.
Nax.
Cherry's back.
Guess when you got. Hi, I've been back for a little bit. You got back just as it ended.
Yeah, it's just about to end. It's been like 2 hours, sorry, so it's just me lecturing everybody.
A good hour and a half.
Guess what?
Yeah?
As I told you, I remember none of it, and I did fall asleep for about 3 minutes.
You can watch the recording whenever you're more alive.
Yeah.
So in 2 to 8 business weeks, thank you.
Of course, of course.
I am sorry.
I'm going to be skipping the whole other part of becoming an Infernal because they skip it themselves and some of their fluff and contradict their own shit. You're not going to be whisked away to Malphia's to overgo like strenuous training and shit. Because that's a thing that they say you do, but you do not at all fucking do 99% of the time. So just ignore that whole thing. I have my own way of handling it. Also, the entire world isn't Asia in this. I want to make that perfectly clear.
You only say that because the kingdom is called the Shogunate, isn't it? Don't you?
I need to clarify that. The entire world is not Asia. And most importantly, it's not Japan. In fact, I'd call it more similar to Qing-era China. Or like Ming China. That kind of shit in terms of like culture and architecture, and also they only like culturally make up like the main island and the coastline for the most part in terms of their cultural influence. The rest of the world is a mix of like Middle Eastern, Amazonian, Greek, fucking Italian, and of it like Europeans over north. So yeah, I have a much more diverse cultural view of it than the writers of this, because they never really had the time or the artistic... They didn't have the budget to fill this out better, so they just kind of gave vague examples of it.
Okay.
Considering all the bullshit that they've already written, I'm not surprised.
Oh, yeah. They had to write so much shit to even make these books and had to commission so much art. It was insane. So they just didn't have the time or the money to write out all the details on this. They just kind of like gave vague descriptions. So I fleshed it out more. I worked and made more writing for all that shit.
Jeez. Okay, so is that it then?
Yeah, unless anybody wants to ask, like, the other countries or, like, the geography.
Do we really want to get into that right now?
Yeah, I may have to roll it into a third later lecture, then.
Oh, isn't there just, like, a map or something you could, like...
No. There's a map. I'll get you... Well, it's not a full map.
I'll put it in the video.
Give me a bit.
Wonder how many copyright claims I'm gonna get on this video.
There's gonna be a
probably
video?
Yeah, just Rita is making a video.
Remember, I just record all of this stuff and then put it in videos.
Hooray, I can
Here's
watch
a map.
It and understand more when I'm not dead.
You may need to rewatch it a couple times.
Oh dear. Alright.
But okay, this is a map. This is the map.
The map, the map, the map, the map, the map, the map, the map.
Are you Dora,
Reader? Yes. Oh, that's a map right there.
Here we go. It's on
this
video now.
A Yeah.
It has taken up most of the screen, and it is the video. It probably can't read any of the names or anything, but it is there.
But, yeah. Oh, yeah, it is Gem, because Gem's off in the middle of fucking nowhere. Okay. Now I remember. I mean, the one with a fucking dinosaur.
Yeah, yes, we... yes, the fucking dinosaur. Oh,
it's not that important.
I know, it's but fine. It's amazing. It's fine.
This is a kind of setting where a forever generating Carnosaur is, like, small. Yeah, this world is terrible, but I love it. I mean, it's terrible for everybody that's living in it.
Yeah.
Also, I should note that this map is, like, fucking not at all to scale, to be perfectly... The world is, like, fucking great. 5 Earths big or some shit.
Oh.
It makes what? Earth look like shit. Oh, no. Dude, it is... And also, it kind of goes infinitely in all directions because go fuck yourself.
That's great.
It's like a different... It's like a different plane of existence. There is space. You can go into space. That is a thing you can do. And it... The world looks like a weird fucked planet. Like, it looks like this. But no, when you're on planet, you can go forever in any direction. Because, of course you can.
Wonderful.
Interesting.
Okay, I'm going to stop the recording now unless you have something super important to say.
Next Friday or Saturday, depending on if there's any other sessions going on, I will be doing an Exalted Mechanics lecture. So, you will all understand how to make your fucking characters and play the game.
Wonderful.
Okay. Probably.
Yeah, I have the next 2 weeks completely open because I still have, yeah.
I will also be running a session on Friday, so, come one, come all.
Okay, I'm gonna be moving into my apartment on campus on Thursday, and I may be busy Friday because of that.
That's reasonable.
That means no recording, big F.
Yeah, that's it. That's the lecture. I hope.